Are you ready to be great? Stop letting self-doubt, insecurity, and fear prevent you from building your business. This morning, wake up to success. Here's John Preston.
Good morning. Thanks for joining us here for Wake Up to Success. Today, I'm going to tell you something that probably no coach has ever told you before. I don't care if it's a sports coach, a fitness coach, a life coach, a business coach. I guarantee you no one's ever told you to stop making plans. Now, sure, we have to have strategies of what we're going to do. We've got to have an outline for how we're going to accomplish the things we want to accomplish. But that's different than making a plan. Often when we make plans, we say, okay, starting Monday, I'm going to cut out all my carbs. I'm going to exercise in the morning, and I'm going to read 3 chapters of this book every morning. That is a plan. But guess what? We're probably not going to do it, because the impetus for us to make that plan should have made us go ahead and start doing the thing we want to do. The problem is, when we make a plan like that, our body actually recognizes it as having done something, even though all we did was make a plan. Studies have shown that when you make a plan to fix something in your life that you want to fix, the mere plan itself gives you an endorphin rush, because now you think at least you're not wandering aimlessly, you're actually moving towards something. But unfortunately, those endorphins don't often hold up long enough for you to begin your plan. I'm guessing with New Year's resolutions just around the corner, just about all of us have already started thinking about what our resolution is going to be come January 1st. The problem with resolutions is, if our actions that we want to make, or those changes we want to make to our life, are so important to us, then why in the world are we waiting until a certain day of the year to begin them? It's because we want to kick the can down the road. When we make a plan, it's really often about not starting now what we know we need to start. Think of the phrase, "I'm going to," and think of how many times during the course of the day you make that statement. I'm going to call that client and find out what's wrong. I'm going to pick up the phone and call more prospects so I can build my business. I'm going to cut back on carbs. I'm going to get to the gym starting next week. When you say things like "I'm going to," you automatically mean, but I'm not going to do it now. Think about that. I'm going to automatically kicks the can down the road. Simply changing those kind of phrases from "I'm going to "I am" or "I will" automatically changes your mindset, because it's not so much about when you're going to start it as it is about that you're going to start it. And the best time to always start anything to make improvements in your life is right now. Because any of those other things is just planning for a future that might not happen. Because come Monday, when your plan's about to start, you might not have the willpower to do something that you have right at this moment. So stop making plans. Stop telling the world what you're going to do, and just do it.